Never heard of. When an email arrives in our inbox, the security-aware person should automatically perform a quick mental authentication to help verify its legitimacy. Would my 18-year-old son send me an email about refinancing our home? Would my ex-husband really send me an email about prescription drugs? Why is my 75-year-old mother sending me an email about PayPal transactions? I didn't think she even knew about PayPal. Spam filters only do so much to weed out the fake emails. Plenty of junk and hostile emails still get through, so the rest of the authentication process is up to you. Unfortunately, our high-speed, distracted lives often force us to make assumptions that are not always in our best interest. Yeah, maybe my son overheard us talking about the mortgage. He probably did send me this refi email. Spammers and scammers know that our distracted brains might make these poor assumptions, thus allowing them to use the names of people we know in the from line and get away with it. Let's say Stephanie Franklin is a family member with whom you communicate daily. Her other handle and nickname is Frankie, so this doesn't look suspicious. Her nickname and email are both displaying correctly, as is the rest of the email. It all seems legit, so you would probably open it despite any suspicion you might have about an email coming from Frankie with this subject line. But did you look at the return path? This is a classic case of spoofing. Most of us think that the from address is the same as the return path, but they are actually very different. When you choose to reply to an email, the email is sent to the return path or reply to email address, whereas the from address is merely the display name. You can set the from address to be anything you want. Since the from address can be spoofed, you should know how to check for the real return path. Every email client can show you what is really going on and display the real reply to return path address. So what